This is crazy! In this video, you are going to learn how to make table functionalities like search, pagination, sorting, and a lot more. So, stay with me. Hey, what's up, guys? Sinead here from CoinPassiveIncome.com, the place where I help others to become a web developer much easier and faster than they will do it on their own. So, if that is something that interests you, consider subscribing. So now I'm here at my PHP store. I've created a new project, jQuery DataTable Tutorial, and also I have created an m2index.php file. I have started my exam server, and inside PHP my admin, I've created a new database, jQuery DataTable, and one table, country. And inside this table, I just have a lot of data, just some names of the country and their country codes, nothing special. So first thing, I'm going to include the Bootstrap because I want to nicely design this table. So I will go to the getbootstrap.com. And by the way, for those of you that are looking to download the source code from this tutorial, you will find in the link in the description below. So I'm going to include this CSS file. You can download it or just do it like this, whatever you like. So this part I will include inside head, and then we don't need anything else. So I'm just going to design it quickly. So I'll say class container, and I'm going to make margin top, for example, 20 pixels, and that's it. And inside this container, I'm going to create one new row, okay? And inside this row, I will say that I will have one class, column MD6, or better, let's say 8, column MD, let's say offset. So if we want it to be on the center, we have 12, 8, 2 and 2, so the offset will be 2. Okay, and that's it. And inside this, I'm going just to create one table. Say table, class, say table. Let's say we want to have a border, so I'll say table bordered. And I'll say table hovered, or hover, I'm not quite sure, but let's see. So here I will have one table head, and inside this table head I will just have one table row with columns, let's say ID, country name, country code, and that's it. And down below I'm going to have table body, and inside this body I'm going just to put everything in from our table. So those table head and table body are required for our plugin that we are going to use to manipulate data inside this table, so just don't forget to include those. And here I'm just going quickly to write PHP code that will get all data from our MySQL database. You can do this dynamically. I'm having another tutorial on how to load and create this table dynamically, but in this tutorial that is really not important, and I want to keep it simple, so I will just write PHP code here. So I will say connection equal new MySQL, and inside here I will say localhost. I'll say my username is root, my password is mtu, and my database name is jQuery DataTable. Okay. jQuery DataTable. Okay. That's it. So now here I will say SQL equal connection query and here I will just say select everything from country. That's it. And of course I'm going to use while loop to get all the data from our table. And for those of you that don't know what this means, I'm just getting one row and putting all the data inside this variable. And if you still don't understand, I also have another tutorial on this topic too. And here we will just say echo, and I will say table row, and we need 3 columns. Okay, and here I will say first one is data. So a little bit faster. Okay, and this is country code, and pretty much that's it. We should be fine. Let's check, refresh, and here we go. So we have nice table and we have all data here. So I think I have made a small mistake here. So yeah, now it's working. So that's it. And now, as you can see, this table is really huge and it is really hard to find any data inside this table, and we do not have any possibility to sort this table. So I'm going to download one jQuery plugin. It's jQuery DataTable, or you can go directly to datatables.net. I didn't know this website, just from my head. And from the left side you have an option download, and there is download the release package and download tables. Okay, and I'm going to save it. Here we go. Okay, save. So now just go to the folder and I will extract here. Just ignore this file. And from this I'm going to the media, and I'm going just to copy those two, and I will delete the files that we don't need. So let me just delete those two. And inside CSS, at the moment we only need this one, so I will just delete this. Okay, and from the JS, all we need is this one and this one. Let's delete those, all others. So that's it. Now if we go back here, we can see we have CSS, okay, and we have JavaScript. So first in the head we also need to include this library. So I'll say like this, and CSS data table, okay. And now down below, just before closing body tag, I'm going to include those libraries. First I will put this one, and then I will put another file. It's this one, okay. And of course we need to include jQuery, so we can just go to the code.jquery.com. I'll choose minified and just copy this. And pretty much now we have all the files that are necessary for this tutorial. So down we are going to write our script. Let's say script type text JavaScript, and here I will say document.ready function which means that we are going first to wait for complete document load to load all table, all libraries, etc. And after that, we are going to execute this part of the code here. So I will say dot table, which means I'm finding the table, the element with class table. And all I need to do is I will just call this plugin. And let's see what will happen. So I will refresh and here we go. And as you can see, without almost any settings, I have got a lot of functionalities. So first is, as you can see at the top, it's added paging and how many elements we want to see. So if I choose 25, it will show 25. Same way with 50, 100, etc. So I'll leave it to the 10. As you can see here, I have sorting. And by default, it's sorted by ID ascending. And if you want descending, just click. And here we go. There's a change, as you can see. The same way sorting is working for the country name, okay, for the country code, etc. Also, there is search functionality. If I just want to find Albania, this is how I do it. Just start typing. Or as you can see, at the moment, we can search by all three columns. So for example, if I want to find the country with ID 55, I can just start typing and here we go. So this is really fast and easy to do. And also down below, we have some informations about how many entries we have and we have some basic pagination. Look how great this is. Okay, it's amazing. But the thing is, sometimes you want to enable or disable some features or you want to make changes. And for that reason, I'm going to show you how to improve this even further. So all I need to do is I will create here an object. And here I'm going just to write some options. So let's say I want to say ordering and I will set to the false. And let's see what will happen. So now when we refresh, if I try to click on the column names, nothing will happen, which means we are not able to sort this table ascending or descending. After that, the next thing, let's say I will say searching and I will set to the false too. Refresh. And search option has gone and I'm not able to search through this table, which is, in my opinion, really bad idea, but it all depends. So the next thing is, let's say paging, I can set to the false, refresh, and as you can see, now we have our basic table that we had at first. So there isn't paging, there isn't search, there isn't ordering, nothing. Just the basic as it was at first. Let me just get back this to true. I'll also get back searching to true because I want to show something. And let's say if I want, for example, we have second, this is our result. And let's say if I want to disable the searching by ID, let's see what will happen. So I will say column definitions and here I will say and here I will just specify, let's say target. And I will say we need to specify the ID of the column. So the ID is 0, country name is 1, and country code is 2. So I want to disable searching for the ID, which is 0. Okay, target 0. and here I will say searchable. Okay, and I will set to the false. Let's refresh. So now if I try to hit number 5, you can see that it says no matching records found. And even if we know there is number 5, if we say 1 or any other. So searching has been disabled for this ID. Also, for example, if we want to hide this column or any other, we can only say false and let's see. Okay, so now we don't have this column at all, which is amazing. Okay, that's it. This is really cool. So let me just back this to the true. And the last thing that I want to show that I think is really important is to be able to set the default sorting. So let's say I will set here order and I will say like this and say I'm targeting column number 2, which is country code, and I want to have sorting by ascending, or let's say descending, and let's see what will happen. Refresh. Okay, so yeah, ordering is set to the false, so we have a problem. We need to get back it to the true and try again, and here we go. And as you can see now from the right side, country code have an option and it's showing us that it's sorted, and it's sorted by descending. So yeah, that works too. Anyway guys, I think this is a very simple and extremely useful tutorial, and if there is any question or something that you don't understand or know how to do, please ask in the comments below. And also, if you like this video, please like it and share it to your friends. Take care.